Hey everyone and welcome back to another Legion video. So Mythic Plus is a brilliant system and today I'm going to give you a whole bunch of universal tips that will help you get better times, therefore get more loot at the end by getting more chests. Now ideally you want the entire group of people to be working on this, but if that isn't happening, you can use all of these tips to help carry the group and prevent having your time or your keystone be wasted. So point number one, and this is the boring one, but communicate, super important. If you see people not using their stuns that you know that they have, politely ask them to start, you know, using their stuns, using their interrupts. This is all stuff that's super important, especially with the interrupts. If a trash mob has kill priority, what you should do is go ahead and mark it with a skull, because generally people will attack the thing with the skull. Now, sometimes pugs are really not the best idea or the best way to do this, but it's a situation that I think can be salvaged if you or, you know, one person in the group is going to take a little bit more leadership and try to help lead the group in the right direction. With that said, let's get into the more tangible advice. First of all, Icy Veins have specific guides for most of the dungeons, and I've seen them just, you know, adding more to that list as times went on. This, I think, is the best way for you to get a specific route that will be very fast while still guaranteeing that you kill all of the mobs that you need to kill in order to be eligible for completion, and will also point out scary trash packs and how to deal with them. So next, the failure detection pylon can be super handy. While you do lose 5 seconds per death on a timer, I think it's more important to realize that that 25 seconds often pales in comparison to the time that it takes to actually run back to where you were after respawning at the start of the instance. Having something like the failure detection pylon can make failure far less punishing to your group, so you never want to have to use it, but it's pretty likely you'll die at some point, and having one of these could be the difference between beating the timer or not beating the time, or hell, even getting a +2 upgrade or a +3 upgrade. Next, I just say bring someone who can avoid death and res their ally. So shamans can use Ankh when they die, and that'll get them back up, and then they can heal people. Hunters can use Feign Death, and then use a Quillen pet to then res a character who can heal the rest of the team. Keeping things like this in mind for your comp is a great way to make sure that any wipes that do happen end up being far less of a problem. So the next tip is to really plan out your class cooldowns. Often what happens is, you know, we think we'll need our cooldown later on, so we don't really use them as much as we actually can. Now, most of the time spent in these Mythic Plus dungeons is spent dealing with trash, and then the damage multiplier of using a cooldown while dealing with an AoE cleave group is pretty damn giant. So be sure to not let your CDs just, you know, sit there off cooldown while you're clearing trash, and eventually you will develop enough game sense to accurately predict the amount of time that you've got left before a boss so you can squeeze in some more cooldowns during the trash. This is something that I'm terrible at, it always slips my mind. So as an example, if you've got a dungeon that's a 35 minute timer, but you're aiming to complete it in 20 minutes so you can get a triple upgrade, and then you have a 3-minute cooldown for your class, you should be able to use that like 6 times in the instance, instead of just maybe the 4 times, one for every boss that you might have already been doing. Those additional 2 times that you use this cooldown will really actually manage to help your time, and really it's the small things that add up to make big time savings. Next, I recommend that you spec appropriately. So, as I mentioned, most of the time that you're in a Mythic Plus, you're dealing with trash, unless you've got maybe a nasty affix that's bolstering up the boss's health. But anyway, this pretty much means that you want to spec away from maybe your more single target focused raid spec and towards more AoE spec. Trash leads to the most wipes in my runs, it takes up the most time, so dealing with trash as quickly as possible is obviously a very good thing. So spec appropriately, but also think a little bit about your comp. We had a Havoc Demon Hunter, a Marksmanship Hunter, and a BM Hunter, so as you can imagine, our specs were just very well lined up for performing quite well in the Mythic Plus dungeons. Next, Invisibility Potions. So these can be a great tool for skipping trash and saving time, but you need to be really wary, because you need to kill a certain amount of trash in any given instance to be eligible for the clear at the end. So once you've maybe planned things out, and you know roughly the mob value in terms of percentage throughout an entire instance, then you can start to work out where you want to use your invisibility potions. If you think about it, if an invis potion can maybe save you, what, 2 minutes? A minute? Because you can often, you know, do a bunch of group-wide speed increases, then chug your invis potion, get a massive skip. If you can actually manage to do that once or twice, that could very easily get you, you know, maybe a +3 upgrade that you perhaps otherwise wouldn't deserve based on just the amount of DPS that you're dishing out. So that can be a pretty handy way to get above the curve. Next, really use all of your utility. So most classes have utility abilities that usually get left alone for a lot of PvE content. And you know, instead they see extensive use in the PvP content. So that's stuff like, you know, your stuns and your CCs that the game has almost trained PvE players away from using as the years have went on. Well, Mythic Plus is really where this stuff should be used. Primarily, it's about using all of the stuns and interrupts that you have access to, and then talenting into these abilities when you can. In many cases, you'll want to stun mobs to reduce the tank damage and then prevent spell casts as well. You'll also want to set up an interrupt rotation for the players who have short, i.e. maybe, you know, 12 seconds or under, cooldown interrupts. So generally what you can do is have the tank and a melee DPS handle most of an interrupt rotation, and then have the ranged characters with their 24 second cooldown interrupts, like say Countershot, just, you know, filling in the gaps as far as an interrupt rotation goes. But in general, just, you know, that stuff. Think about using your knockbacks all the time, because knockbacks will, you know, they'll interrupt because it moves the mob. In the higher level keystones, there are some trash packs that are quite a problem, especially I'm thinking of the level 6 that we did in the demon area of Arkway, which was really kind of problematic. Sometimes you need to take down trash really methodically to prevent a wipe, so in those cases, using your hard CC to prevent the group from descending into madness is a really good idea. Overall, I would recommend using weak ores for these abilities so that you always know if they're off cooldown, and generally I find that makes me a bit more aware of the sort of the cooldown of my wider toolkit. So next, trash matters. Bar a few keystone affixes, trash is your main issue, so keep this in mind when you're planning your ability usage throughout the run. In lower level keystones, it can actually be worth planning around this fact. So, let's just say you've got a really good tank, and you've got a pretty good group comp for doing lots of AoE damage. In that case, it can actually be a pretty good idea to chain pull packs of mobs, mass stun them, have a stun rotation going, and AoE them down really fast. For an example, two hunters and a demon hunter. So between us, we have Chaos Nova, we have two binding shots, so we can keep trash packs stunned for quite a while, which allows us to benefit from insane levels of cleave DPS and, in the process, save us quite a lot of time. Now, this is mainly something that we'll be thinking about for our future optimizations. We were playing it a bit more tentatively because we're still kind of getting used to the system and how it works. But eventually, you know, if you think about how much the trash overall matters, and then think about the full toolkit that your team has, we're actually getting into the same realm of gameplay as when you're trying to go for a gold challenge mode back in, say, the Mists of Pandaria challenge mode system. A lot of that gameplay and a lot of that sort of thought process ends up mapping super well onto Mythic Pluses because, I guess in many ways, they are pretty similar. So with that mentioned, I just say make the tank's life easier. So a really important part of increasing your group's DPS output is making your tank happy. Why is this? Well, if all the mobs are clumped up, they're going to all be taking cleave damage. If you're cleaving 3 out of 5 mobs in a pack, but you just let the other 2 casters just chill out and take hardly any damage, then your time to kill that pack will be a lot slower. This is something that everyone can help the tank out with. So if you're a Death Knight, you can, you know, death grip some casters into the tank's clump. If you're a ranged DPS, you can interrupt or silence casters so they're forced to run into melee. You always want to be thinking about how you can help your tank out and allow these things to happen. Doing this decreases running time, it maximizes your cleave damage, and over multiple mob packs, this will lead to a pretty sizable time gain. And then finally, target fire. Now, this is really more relevant to the higher end mythics, but you really need to enforce target firing of certain mobs in a trash pack, whether they get purely single targeted down or are just your primary focus, as like a cleave target. It's often really important to deal with the scary mobs first. Once again, that demon area in the Arkway is really coming to mind. Now, doing this is often a bit tricky in a pug, so I recommend that you just mark something that needs to die quickly with a skull, because most people will naturally gravitate towards that target. There are also some more, I think, role-based things as far as target firing goes. So as an example, if we were to think of the Valkyrie mob just before Herja, I think, in Halls of Valor, the one that jumps around the place. Now, if you're a ranged player, you should just be focusing on getting that mob that's jumping everywhere killed, and then your melee DPS shouldn't actually be focusing on that, because them running around chasing this mob isn't really that helpful. So you need to think about if there's a mob that's doing a lot of movement, and if you're a ranged character, you want to be focusing that down so you can let your melee DPS players maximize their damage by not having to move around the place and fight stuff. Really, a lot of this stuff does just come down to having pretty good game sense. And I suppose I'm just going to round this off with just reinforcing that every second really, really counts. Our very first triple chest upgrade was within 3 seconds of being 2 chests. Now, every second that somebody is slow really does add up. If, you know, somebody just did one tiny, tiny, silly mistake, then our run would have only been 2 chests, and that would have been a lot less efficient as far as the time that we put in. So while a lot of the things that I'm saying here seem really small, and they seem like nitpicks, they really do add up. If following each tip here led to a small decrease on a 35-minute timer, then there's a good chance that overall, you know, that's going to lead to maybe 2 minutes, maybe 3 minutes. And they'll be the 3 minutes that will probably determine whether you're a 3-chest upgrade or a 2-chest upgrade. But yeah, doing all those little things, kind of, you know, gotta go fast, playing with that mentality, is likely going to get you a pretty good reward. And at the end of the day here, you know, the difference between running 3 dungeons and getting a +1 upgrade, and 1 dungeon and getting a +3 upgrade, you know, the only difference there is that in one scenario you get the same amount of loot for maybe 3 times the amount of time that's put in, whereas if you just do it fast and do it right the first time, well, in that case, you're getting the same amount of loot for doing a third of the work. You just need to make sure the work that you do is done well. And it's an interesting system that it really does promote playing well. I've seen a lot of criticisms though, and a lot of people aren't really the happiest about the entire aspect with the timer. That's not really the point of this video, you know, criticisms aside, the system is what it is, and this is more about making the best out of that. And then just finally, those Icy Veins guides, they'll really help you optimize on a dungeon by dungeon basis, if that's the kind of thing you want to do. But anyway guys, that's pretty much it for this video. Let me know what you think over on Twitter, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.